You're here because you want to know if it's okay to leave someone with depression. I'm going to share a little bit of my personal experience and the choice I made, and then I'm going to share with you the one powerful thing you need to know to protect your own mental health and your own future happiness as you make this decision. Before we get to that powerful thing, I want to tell you two important things. First is the decision I made. I stayed. I am still married to my husband. He still struggles with depression. Part of the reason I made that choice is because of the amazing things that I am learning on this journey of loving this incredible person. And yes, his depression is part of that. But the second thing, and this is so important for you to hear, is you don't have to make the decision that I made. You can leave. It is okay to leave someone with depression. It is okay to stay with someone with depression. Either choice is all right. And you are not going to hear that from a lot of people. So I want you to really hear it from me. It is okay either way. The only thing that is not okay for you right now is this belief that doing one or the other, either staying or leaving, is going to fix things, right? You want to feel calm. You want to feel peaceful. You want to feel happy and connected and loved. That is what you want. And right now, it really feels like you have to do something dramatic. Either stay and commit to this person or leave and get away from this. Stop drowning in the ocean with them. You need to do something dramatic in order to get that peace, that calm, that happiness, that love, and that connection. But the thing is that staying or leaving, taking or not taking an action is not going to help. It's not going to create those things for you. I'm going to explain to you what will create that in your life, regardless of which decision you make. And if you're doubting this, if you're like, yeah, no, Rachel, big change is what I need. That's going to make me feel better. Let me tell you, I have been there. I have made so many big changes in my life. I changed majors. I have changed careers. I have gone to and dropped out of veterinary school. In 6 years, I have lived in 5 states and 2 countries. Before I met my husband, I dropped partners easily. A year, 2 years in, not happy, okay, gone. Never thinking about you again, doing something different. I have made huge, dramatic changes, cutting people in and out of my life, changing my entire future, moving, changing towns, changing jobs. You guys, I'm going to tell you something. It works for a minute, right? Doing that big change feels good for a moment. It's exciting. It's energizing. It feels different. And that lasts for like a week or maybe a month. And then all of a sudden, like, you just end up right back where you were, because I bring my brain with me everywhere I go. I bring my habits of thinking with me everywhere I go, to every relationship I am in. And it is those habits of thought. It is my brain creating my emotional experience, not the state I live in, not the partner I'm married to, not the job I have. Changing a circumstance, changing a partner, leaving a marriage, these make it momentarily easier to think new thoughts, right? A big change creates an easy opportunity for your brain to think something different, to have hope for a new future, to feel excited about a change, right? Possibility, new thoughts are accessible to you during that big change and immediately after. But if you're not managing your mind, if you don't know how to intentionally work with your thoughts, how to break old habits of thinking, how to intentionally learn new ones, if you don't know how to unwire and rewire your brain, those new, hopeful, exciting possibility thoughts are going to wear off. Your old habits of thought are going to come back and you are going to be right back. You're going to find yourself in a new relationship with a new partner, feeling frustrated, feeling anxious, feeling overwhelmed. Even if that partner's not depressed, this habit of thinking and feeling that you have in your current relationship is going to follow you if you don't learn how to do the work on your own thoughts and your own feelings. For most of my life, for my entire adult life, I have tried to escape anxiety, to escape sadness and frustration and resentment and overwhelm. I have tried to do it by moving. I have tried to do it by changing partners, by changing my environment, by changing my career path. I have tried over and over and over. It never lasted. It never worked for any length of time beyond that initial change. It never stuck until I learned how to unwire and rewire my brain. until I learned how to let go of emotional habits, of thought habits that didn't serve me, and intentionally create new habits, new ways of being in the world, new ways of thinking in the world. That is what is bringing lasting peace, lasting calm, lasting joy to my life. And guess what? I learned how to do that during one of the hardest times with my husband's depression, during one of the darkest moments where I thought I was going to drown with him, where I thought we were both going to go down and never be happy again. That, in that moment, staying in that place is where I finally found this work, where I finally learned the tools to change the way I think and the way I feel, and to finally realize that it's not him. It's not the state I live in, the house I live in, the job I go to work at. None of that is what is creating my emotional experience. I finally was able to learn the tools to show that to myself and to take some control over what is happening in my mind and in my heart and in my day-to-day life. And so as I learned that, I have chosen to stay in my marriage. You might make a different choice, right? There is no right or wrong choice here. You can leave, you can stay. It honestly doesn't matter which you do, because either way, you're going to have your brain with you. It's coming along for the ride. Whether you stay in this relationship, whether you move on and go on to something else, you're taking your thoughts, you're taking your emotions with you, and you have habitual ways of thinking. You have belief systems, and those are tied to habitual experiences and cycles of emotion. So if you're struggling with anxiety and frustration and overwhelm in response to your partner's depression, and you leave and go end up with somebody who's not depressed, you are going to find yourself feeling anxious and frustrated and overwhelmed about something else. Maybe it's about the partner. Maybe it's about your job. Maybe it's about your children. It's going to keep coming up until you unlearn that habit of thinking and feeling. The same is true if you stay with your partner. If you stay with your partner and you don't do this work, things are not going to change. Even if your partner's depression gets better, even if they start to get happier, this is actually fascinating, guys, because I think you'll recognize this cycle in yourself. What used to happen to me is that when he would start to feel better, when the depression would lift, that's when I would get bad. That's when I would get really anxious and really frustrated and really angry. It was almost like the better he felt, like the more magnified those emotions got for me. And then he would get depressed and I would feel them still. It was like, it didn't matter. If I really paid attention, it didn't matter where he was at in that cycle of depression. I was still anxious. I was still frustrated. I was still angry, usually at him, sometimes at me, right? I was still experiencing shame and guilt around all of those emotions because it wasn't ever him. It wasn't ever what he was doing. It wasn't ever the town I lived in, right? It was never anything outside of my own habits of thought and my own habits of feeling. So what you have to learn to do if you want that calm, that peace, that joy, that freedom, it's not, there's no action you can take that will give you those things. You can't act your way into feeling happier. You have to think your way into being happier. You have to learn to recognize the triggers and the cycles of thought and emotion that you're currently living in. You have to become aware of them, see how they play out, notice when they're happening, and then gently start to intentionally replace them with new habits of thinking, with new habits of feeling. If that sounds daunting and you don't know where to start, book a free strategy session with me. There are a couple of ways I can help you work through this and lay out the roadmap, the pathway to your happiness, to your peacefulness, to that calm, regardless of whether you choose to stay or leave your partner. And I want you to know, I want you to hear that again, it's okay. Either choice is okay. I feel like you are not going to hear that enough. I will never judge you for that decision you make, and I will help you work through any shame or guilt you have around staying or around leaving. Because the action is not what's important. It is not at the root of your suffering, and it is not going to fix it for you. What is going to fix it for you is learning to unwire and rewire your thoughts and your emotions. When you learn to do that, you become like a superhero. You can create intentionally the kind of life, the kind of experience, the kind of relationships that you want. And I am not talking about manifestation. I am not talking about tricking your brain into believing things that aren't true. I'm talking about slowly, systematically, gently questioning and reshaping your perspectives, about learning to love and accept yourself in a deep way so that you can give yourself the validation, the strength, and the love that you need, so that you can give yourself the compassion that you need to heal from your old wounds, from your past traumas, and to move forward into the life that you want to create with intention. Maybe your partner and their depression is part of that. Maybe it isn't. Honestly, that is not the important question. The important question is, are you ready to take ownership of what you're experiencing? Are you ready to understand your thoughts, to understand your emotions? And are you ready to start choosing who you want to be, how you want to show up, and how ultimately you want to feel about yourself when you wake up tomorrow? Those are the important questions. Those are the questions that will start to change your life, whether you stay or whether you leave. I hope this video is helpful. I know there's a lot in here, and I know that the way forward can seem really muddy. If it looks muddy to you, please use the link in the description below, book a call with me. I will help you see that path forward really clearly so that you know every step along the way, you know where you need to go and what you need to do to get to that calm, that peace, that confident, that loved, that connected space that you want in your relationship and in your life. All right, you guys, a wonderful, wonderful day. I know you're going through a lot. I'm here for you. Be there for yourself. Okay, I'll talk to you soon.